Hey everyone, today we're going to be looking at how to use something like your Pod HD500X or a Helix or any multi-effects processor that has a certain number of ins and outs and use that as a setup for in-ear monitors. The Pod HD has a microphone input with its own volume control here, and we can route that to a separate signal chain from the guitar signal. So that's what we're going to use to mix our monitor feed back into our in-ears. And for that matter, this could be sent to a powered monitor as well. The second thing that you need is a stereo effects loop. We have a stereo effects send right over here with two mono returns, and that's the other ingredient that is key to this setup. Now, the equipment you're gonna need is pretty basic. It's some stereo, here we are, a stereo TRS, or whatever your device sends a signal out through. Mine happens to be a TRS coming out left and right, and it's a Y cable going to two mono. And one of these is going to be sent out to our PA or amp, or wherever you want to send your guitar signal. The other one is going to come back into the pod through the effects return for our own monitoring. One handy little addition is just a barrel connector. If you want to be able to send this with a longer cable to your amp or to whatever signal is going to receive that, you can use something basic like this. Or if you're going to be going into a DI, you can send one of those mono sends directly into a DI. So let's have a look at how this is going to patch together on the floor. So let's start with the signal path coming from the guitar and follow it through the pod and into the amp and into our in-ear headphone monitors. We're going to start off with this cable, and what I've done here is I've just taken my regular patch cord for the guitar and a headphone extension cable and taped them together. So on one end I have the headphone output, the guitar, and on the other end I have the other end of the guitar cable and a quarter inch version of the headphone. So to follow the signal path, we'll start at the guitar, and that's going to send our signal just normally into the guitar input, which is going to be processed by one of the signal paths of the pod. Then we're going to be monitoring that with our headphone output directly on the pod. And the way it's going to work out in the end is that our master volume will control our in-ear volume without affecting the signal that's sent to the PA or to your amp. So from there, the signal is processed on path A. This is broken up into left and right, A and B. So we're gonna send A as our guitar signal and B as our monitor signal. So now what we need to do is send this guitar signal out to the PA. And for that, we're going to use our stereo cable. And I've made my own here, but you can use a regular TRS to two TR cables. And we're gonna take our stereo effects out right here, the stereo send. And remember that this is going to be taking a mono signal. If you send a stereo signal with, say you've got a left and right ping pong delay or something like that, you're not going to be able to get that stereo signal both into your ears and to the PA. You're gonna have to stick with mono effects for this to work best. One of the signals, they've got a left and a right here, is going to go back in to our effects return. So we're gonna go left mono, return, and that will send the effects loop just directly back into our headphone mix, which is gonna be controlled by our master volume. The other side of the stereo effects send is going to go to the PA into a DI box, or if you want to send it into your guitar amp, you can use a barrel connector and whatever length of cable you need to send that over to your amp. So if you're using a mono setup, that's the simplest way to get your signal in and out. But if you'd like to get a stereo signal for your effects,
say you're using some stereo effects that you don't want to lose that going to this mono system, the simple thing you could do there would be to take two DI boxes, because most DI boxes have a pass-through. So you could send your left and right from the stereo effects loop into two separate DI boxes, then take the pass-through from each of those DI boxes and bring two signals back into the pod into the left and right effects loop returns. That way, you get your full stereo sound both sent to the PA and into your in-ears.
So now we've got guitar signal coming in, processed, and I've got my effects send at the very end of my guitar signal chain. So after all the delays and reverbs, the fully processed sound is going out to the amp or PA and coming back in for my monitoring. Next thing we need is our monitor mix coming from the soundboard. So we will take a balanced XLR signal coming from the soundboard, send that into the microphone input, which is now adjustable by the volume, so we can blend in the amount of that monitor mix that we want to hear in our ears. And that's going to blend with our guitar signal and come out of the headphones. And that's controlled by our master volume. So that's the routing on the back of the pod. And the rest is all done internally in the software, so we'll have a look at that. The first thing you need to do in order to separate your guitar signal from your monitor signal is to move all your guitar processing effects and amp into this path on the top so that you separate your guitar path from your monitor path. And one of those effects blocks will need to be changed into an effects loop. So we'll take the very last one here and we'll make that an effects loop. And that needs to be on when you have your cables plugged in for your effects send and return. Now this bottom path here has nothing in it. It's completely empty, and that's going to accept our monitor signal. So now we need to assign the inputs in the pod menu by holding down the view button and scroll down a couple of pages. Page 3 here shows us that input 1, which is going into that top path, is our guitar signal, and input 2 is accepting the microphone signal. Now we could technically use the auxiliary input on the back and put a 1/4-inch input into that and have a monitor coming into that input, but it doesn't have a volume control on the back for that, so I find that it's a little more flexible to have the mic accepting an XLR input. Then we get to the very end, and the last thing is our mixer. Now this will blend both of those two paths. Dial 1 is volume A, our guitar signal, so we can adjust that, the output of that towards our headphone monitors, and volume B is the monitor input coming from the soundboard. So we can adjust volumes independently, and we can also adjust the pan. I can take the guitar signal and pan it left if I want to hear it more in my left ear, and say the instruments, vocals, other instruments coming back from the monitor mix more to my right ear. And that gives me complete control over the panning of my in-ear monitors. What this allows us to do is to now have our in-ear monitor mix, the blend of guitar signal and monitor signal, adjustable in our ears with this master volume. But that will not affect the amount of guitar signal going out to the PA. The guitar signal will be affected by your channel volume and all of your amp controls. But this will just affect your ears, and the volume control of the microphone input on the back will blend in the amount of other instruments and vocals. One of the benefits of this kind of a setup is that you have complete control over your guitar signal coming back into your own ears. You don't have to worry about the sound guy unmuting your channel and having it come back through the soundboard,
or having an EQ on the soundboard affect your tone. Everything you're hearing in your ears is coming directly off your device, unaffected by anything else. And you don't need any batteries. It's all powered by the one device. So it's a pretty simple and a reliable system. I hope you found this video useful. And if you've got different ideas about how you can use the pod to accomplish these sorts of things, post those in the comments below. Or if you've got questions about how it might fit into your setup and you want me to address those in a future video, post that down there too.